We are in La Bride, France, where Montesquieu was born, and this location relates to Montesquieu's ideas in the Enlightenment.
Montesquieu believed government power should be divided into three branches.
Montesquieu divided the government into the legislative, judicial, and executive branches.
He talked about his ideas in his most famous book, The Spirit of Laws, in 1748, describing his ideas about the organization of the government.
He was also concerned with protecting political liberty, which also helped fuel his ideas to separate the government into branches.
Montesquieu's ideas would later influence the U.S. Constitution with the separation of powers.
Here in Paris, the birthplace of Voltaire, he contributed exquisite ideas to the Enlightenment. He wanted to reform society to improve justice and human happiness. Voltaire thought religious conflict was the main source of evil in the world.
Voltaire had to flee other cities and countries when his opinion made him unpopular. Voltaire was imprisoned twice for his beliefs of freedom. He valued the freedom of thought, speech, expression, and religion tolerance.
We are in Milan, Italy, and this place relates to Cesare Beccaria's ideas about the Enlightenment.
Beccaria wrote a book called On Crimes and Punishments. In his book, he said laws exist to establish security and order.
He also believed that punishment should be severe enough to outweigh benefits of a crime, but not too harsh.
He thought people accused of crime should get a fair and speedy trial, which is now part of the Sixth Amendment.
Lastly, Beccaria thought punishments for the same crime should be the same, and that capital punishment should be gotten rid of.
Those are some of Cesare Beccaria's ideas during the Enlightenment.
Hi, and welcome to Timbuktu.
Timbuktu, Mali, contained three African kingdoms, Ghana, Mali, and Sao Paulo.
First was Ghana, which became successful by collecting taxes from trade on all goods entering and leaving the kingdom.
Ghana collapsed because of the Almoravids, devoted Muslims, took control of trade routes and later the entire empire.
However, it was soon taken again by the Kingdom of Mali.
When Mali collapsed, Sani Ali made Songhai strong by taking control of trade routes and rich cities like Timbuktu.
It became the largest state to ever exist in West Africa.
Songhai collapsed when people argued over succession.
When Songhai was weakened, the Sultan of Morocco defeated it for its gold and salt mines.
We're in Chichen Itza, Mexico, home of the Maya.
In 300 BC, the Maya were building cities.
By 250 AD, the Maya began to their golden age, called the Classic Period.
The Mayas were resourceful because of their two farming methods that allowed agriculture to be successful in a tropical environment.
Their first method was to burn down forests and clear land to plant crops for farming. This method was a repeating process that provided a steady source of food for the empire.
The second method was where the Mayans left old farmlands because they weren't fertile and they burned down new forests to farm.
These two methods help the Maya produce enough crops to support their growing city.
Thanks for watching.
We're in Mexico City, Mexico, and this place relates to the Aztecs.
They needed a sign from their gods, a bird with a snake in its mouth on top of a cactus. They found this sign in Lake Texcoco, and that's where they built their capital.
This location is now present-day Mexico City. The Aztecs emperor led the war. The Aztecs were polytheistic, which means they believed and worshipped many gods.
Aztecs believed that gods had created the world multiple times. They existed here until 1519, when they were conquered by the Spanish.
Hi, and welcome to Machu Picchu. This city relates to the Incas. In 1438, Pachacuti Inca Yapanqui said he was Sapa Inca, the emperor. He had a small kingdom in Cusco. However, he started increasing the size.
The Sapa Inca had absolute power and owned all the property in the kingdom. This resulted in no trade in the Inca Empire. The emperor was also the religious leader and stated that he was the son of the sun.
The Sapa Inca made people learn their language, Quechua, and follow their religion. Overall, the Inca Empire had a population of 10 million. This is until the Spanish conquered them in 1532.
Thank you.